everyone, and welcome to my new Dory paint video. You know it already, if I have my shirt with stars on, it means today we're going to make another Zodiac doll. And now in the end of June, we're stepping into a Cancer season, and it's time for me to make a Cancer doll. So greetings to all my Cancer people, happy birthday, have the very best month of you. And Cancer is obviously a water sign, and it's also summertime, at least here in Belgium it's extremely hot. Really guys, I'm melting now here sitting under all these lamps. Yeah, so the plan is to combine the water element and the summer energy. And as a model for this transformation, I'm going to use this Draculaura doll because I just need some very sweet and very cute face today. And I'm going to start like always with removing her outfit, taking all these accessories off, and then I'm going to cut her hair as short as I can. Then I'm going to use hot air of my hair dryer to make the hat soft and to melt the old glue inside of the hat. And then later I can easily take the hat off and pull out the rest of the short hair that is still sitting inside. Now let's take pure acetone, some cotton pads and Q-tips, and we're going to remove her original makeup. After this, I'm going to sand the body to remove the glossy top from its surface, and then I will spray the head and the body with a couple of layers of light acrylics using my airbrush. To be able to draw on the rubber doll's face, I've sprayed it with a couple of layers of this Mr. Super Clear sealant, and now we're going to create a new face for this doll using these pencils and soft pastels. And today we're going to create a very surprised face. Later I will explain you the reason why she's so surprised, but for now let's just concentrate on the face. So the eyes should be very wide open, and the eyebrows are going more up to the forehead. And the mouth I'm going to make very round and kind of half open, like a surprised mouth. And then I slightly blush her face to create a realistic skin tone and to give her natural shadows. After this, I draw her face in color, and today I'm going to draw first the white of her eyes with shadows and with everything, and then after protecting this layer with the sealant, I will draw the blue irises on top of it. Her mouth requires some extra work today because it's quite a big transformation, but I also think Draculaura with her very soft molded face is just ideal for it. You can do kind of whatever you want with her lips. Then it's time for the highlights, and this step will put everything together and her face will become immediately more realistic. You know, I love false doll lashes, but I also feel a little bit like they can steal a part of facial expression and kind of hide a part of my work. So today I'm going to draw her lashes again, the same like in my Billie Eilish video last week, and I think it looked really good. And by the way, I'm so happy you loved my Billie doll, because making famous people is always more pressure for me than freestyling like today, but both are fun anyway. Now let's also blush her body, and then I'm going to give her very light freckles. I think they would really fit the character of this doll, and freckles are also always so extremely summerish. So I mix a couple of acrylics together to create a color just a little bit darker than her skin tone. Then I dilute this paint with water, and I spray these freckles all over using a hard synthetic brush. And here it's very important to try it first on some piece of paper to remove the excess of paint. And some messy spots I can quickly clean up with Q-tips. After this, I still need to add reflections to her eyes using white acrylics, and when the paint dries completely, I apply a layer of glossy acrylic varnish to her eyes and lips. Okay, now let's talk about her outfit, and today my plan is to send my doll to spend her weekend somewhere outside of the town, probably fishing, maybe picnic, you know, some kind of outdoor activities. That's why I've asked my mom to make some very appropriate outfit for this fishing picnic, and here is actually her work in progress footage. So here is the outfit, and I still want to make quite a lot of accessories for our doll today, and I'm going to start with a pair of rain boots, and I'm going to sculpt them using this seal clay. Honestly, I've never done it before in my life, but I really hope it will work. Let them dry overnight, and now let's cut them open on the back to be able to take them off and then to put them on again. And now I'm going to cover the boots with acrylics, and I think I want to make super sunny and happy yellow rubber boots. In the end, I cover them with glossy acrylic varnish, and our boots look amazing, I think. Okay, now let's make a fishing rod for our doll, and first of all, I'm going to cover this barbecue stick with two colors of acrylics. The shorter part I color with a dark brown color, and then the longer part I keep very light. Then I take such a wire, and I wrap it around the place where these two colors come together. Now let's make a spinning reel, and for this I'm going to connect together these three buttons. The bigger ones will be on the outside, and the small one will be between the two bigger ones. Then I take a very thin wire and I spool it around our spinning reel. I glue this construction to the barbecue stick. I still want to make a handle for the spinning reel. Then I fix the thin wire to the longer part of the stick with two pieces of the thick wire. And then I cover the colorful buttons with silver acrylics. And now let's finally make a reason why our doll looks so surprised. I think it's probably because she catches some sea monster or something like this. And this sea monster I'm going to sculpt now using this epoxy sculpt. So I'm going to create some sort of a crawfish, because the word cancer actually means crab in Latin. And that's why crab, crawfish and a lobster, how to call it, has become the symbol of this zodiac sign. The next day, when the clay got completely dry, I can color our lobster monster with acrylics, and I think I want to make it red. I know they're green in nature and they become red as a result of us cooking them, but I just like it more red. It would fit better our colorful summery paint, and the dark green one would make just no contrast with her outfit. And after all, maybe that's why she's so scared and surprised, because it's for sure a surprise to catch a cooked lobster out of the river. Then I can make a hook and attach it to the wire of our fishing rod. And here I have also prepared an extremely cute tiny bucket for the future take. And with all these lobsters and rain boots, I have completely forgotten I still need to make a wig for her, because to me it felt already completely finished, but then some important detail still was missing. So I'm going to use this acrylic yarn to make a wig for her, and if you watch my videos regularly, you know that I'm completely in love with this yarn wigs nowadays, because just this very fine fiber looks more like real hair on this tiny doll scale. So let's do it again, all the process. So first of all, I cut it. Then I tie the pieces around some barbecue sticks. Then I make this yarn loose. And after this, I brush it with this brush for cats. It's my favorite part. After this, I'm making it flat with a hair straightener. And then I can cut it and glue it to some plastic surface. And then I make a wig for my doll using my regular glue gun technique. So now let's put it all together and then we'll take a look at the end result pictures. So, and here is my excited and very surprised cancer girl. And I'm so happy about how colorful and how cartoonish she looks. And she also perfectly expresses my summer feelings. I was scared a little bit this lobster would be too heavy for her to hold it on the rod, but there is a way to find a balance. You need to fix the end of this rod between her legs. Sorry for this detail, but no worries. I also adore her facial expression. I think she's one of the best ones. And what do my cancer people think? I really hope you enjoy it, guys, because it's 100% dedicated to you. And I also wanted to ask you, what kind of lashes do you like most on dolls? The fuzz lashes or the drone lashes like today? Because I can't decide it myself what direction to go. And this doll will be available on eBay till the end of this weekend. The link is in the description box, so if you wanted to adopt one of my dolls, she is available. That was my doll transformation of the week. I wish one more time happy birthday to all my cancer people here. Please don't forget, guys, to support my art here on YouTube with your likes, because this is very important. This is what helps me to grow, to develop, and to make more dolls all the time. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you are new here. I upload new doll repaint videos every week Friday, and it means we will see each other already very soon next week in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.